Here's a riddle for you. What do we get when we cross someone with a family of gourmets and a passionate Colombian? Well, today, we are going to answer that for you. I'm Beth Holbrook with the Zions Bank Business Resource Center, and I'm here today with Trent Farger, the owner and operator of Shades of Hell Brewing Company, and we're here today talking about his experience with the Business Resource Center. Thanks for joining us today, Trent. We appreciate it. So tell me, what's the answer to the riddle? How do we deal with a family of gourmets and a passionate Colombian?
Well, we get world-class beer and artistic design within our labels, all combined into one package.
Wow, that's fantastic. So give me a little bit of background as to how this all started. How did your business start?
Well, we got started in the kitchen back in 93, and so the brewing actually happened from a home brew perspective. You know, pots on the stove, overflowing, stickiness, you know, sometimes we had explosions in the fermentation process, that kind of thing.
Oh my gosh.
And then we moved into the garage. And then once we moved into the garage, you know, my wife was okay with that for a while. And then pieces, parts started taking over the garage and it got bigger. So we had to move into a bigger garage where we are today. And now we've got more professional equipment and we have larger explosions.
Larger explosions.
I'm just kidding. No.
Oh, that's great. No, that's perfect. Everyone wants to hear that. Yeah. So our situation's a little different. I actually came up to visit your facility up in Park City. So let's tell people how that evolved.
Sure. So we're in the process of moving forward and raising funds for our next expansion. We've gotten to the point where we are as big as we can get in our location. Mm-hmm. We need a larger facility. We need larger tanks and other things to be able to brew more product. Okay. Currently, we have three styles of beer: our Jack Wagon Wheat, our Publican Pale Ale, and our Foreplay Porter. And we'd like to add to those styles. And in order for us to add to those styles, we need to have more equipment and a larger facility. So that being said, we were looking for SBA funding, and that's how we got involved with Zions Bank, somebody that would potentially be able to help us. And you were able to come up, see the facility, and start working with us from that standpoint.
Tell me about some of the early struggles that you guys faced as business owners, you and Alexandra.
Well, certainly there's government regulation and taxation and things that happen, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. But the biggest struggles were really the build-out of the building and taking a building that wasn't designed to be a brewery and retrofitting it into the brewery and all things we had to do in order to be able to get up to code and regulation. That meant cutting in the floors, putting in extra supports on the second floor, and watching my wife with a 14-inch cutoff saw doing concrete work, which was a lot of fun. So we did a lot of the work ourselves, and we're able to get through all those hoops and be able to get the equipment installed and start brewing.
Okay, so you have a unique approach. Tell me about your unique approach and how this works in the market in Park City.
Sure. Shades of Pale Brewing Company really started around Park City and being up in Park City and the mountain lifestyle. And so we wanted to incorporate that into not only our beer that we're producing, but into our labeling of our products as well, so that we would have a differentiator in the marketplace just beyond great quality beer. We have something that we can offer somebody as a value add over and beyond just what's in the package. Mm-hmm. So on the label itself, we've created what's called an adventure in a bottle, and we've put a map of an adventure on our label that somebody can partake, whether they be local and or maybe just new to the community and not aware of some of the different things that are available. It could be a hiking trail, it could be a mountain biking trail, backcountry ski adventure, snowshoeing, anything related to outdoors and the mountain lifestyle. So that once they partake in that or whatever else they're doing, and hopefully with our products, they can then have memories and share those with friends and family and other people that they're associating with. So camaraderie, mountain lifestyle, friendship, and sharing, that's what we're all about.
That's a great niche market. Trent, thank you so much for joining me today. I appreciate it. To see more videos like this, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.